Okay, so welcome back. So today we're going to talk about copyrights, and this is where we're trying to protect our creative works. So what does that mean and what does that really get us? Well, it's kind of a flexible notice format to others that, hey, I've copyrighted this material, so I'm claiming it, or my company's claiming it, and we have the rights to use it. For you to use any of this, you have to get rights from us. So there are several different ways you can format this. So for example, you could say copyright, and if you notice they have the circle C here, 2017 Google Incorporated, all rights reserved. So that's about as formal as it gets. You have all of this. Now, that's great for a book, it's great for a CD, it's great for a website, or even software. However, you may want to put multiple dates, like from when you started claiming it as a copyright and then continue through whatever the current date is. Or you can have an abbreviated version, like copyright with the circle C symbol, 2017 Google, or copyright Google. There's all sorts of different formats. If you're in doubt, do the full format if you've got the room to do it. That's just the one that's most noticed. It can be very industry specific. So for example, there are a whole bunch of industries, they call them the three F's, that you cannot have a copyright. And that surprises people. So for example, fashion, food, and furniture, there is no copywriting available. In fact, you can't get a patent either because they're considered utilitarian designs. So it varies by country, but in general, this is true with those. Utilitarian just means that it's so ubiquitous and everybody uses it that you're not allowed to protect it as intellectual property. So that goes for recipes, it goes for certain furniture looks, like a chair is a chair, so they're not gonna let you patent a chair. Doesn't mean you couldn't get maybe a design patent for certain things, for the look and feel, but as far as a utility patent, you're not gonna get that. Now, fashion's kind of wide open. Everybody borrows from everybody. So, to look at that, Johanna Blakely makes a great argument on what does it look like from the fashion perspective and a lot of these other things. All right, great. So, if you notice, there's huge industries that don't rely on the intellectual property the way we've seen it. So, if you notice what they are relying on, particularly in the fashion industry, is the previous conversation on trademarks and branding, not on copyrights. And that's how they get the value of what they're doing. So that's why when you see something that's Gucci or something like that, it's really the symbols that they plaster all over everything. It's not the actual design of the bag itself or something like that. So how long do you get protection for? Well, roughly, give or take, about 70 years for new creations. There is some differences based upon the type of creation it is. But that's actually an extremely long time, and it's more protection time than you get with any of the other forms of intellectual property. Now, there is a movement to not have hard and fast copyrights with a 70-year protection. There are and has been a movement to what we call Creative Commons. So default copyright ownership is the circle C, where it's owned by the creator, author, artist, unless they agree otherwise. And if you use it otherwise, they can come after you. So that's the default way that it's set up. The only way you can get access to it is either you got to license it or they have to sign it to you. Another level is the right to make copies. And so this arises simply by creating a work. It protects the expression, not the idea. So this works fine for music, but it's not very good for software. All the way to the other end where it's fully open source. And open source is where it's fine, you can share, you can build off of it, you can copy, and if you want to register it, fine, it doesn't matter. So this Creative Commons is actually a newer way of looking at copyrights. So, and it's also the least restrictive. And even within Creative Commons, there's variation. So, for example, I borrowed this slide from a Creative Commons use. If you notice, it shows here. So Shyam Donnelly is the person who created this and then had a Creative Commons license to be able to use this. And it's great because it really kind of shows you the different levels of accommodation. So the most restrictive is on this end, the most accommodating is on this end. So the most accommodating is a CC and it shows by, and you notice it's a little symbol of a person. Well, that just means attribution. It means you can copy, distribute it, display, perform, remix, as long as you attribute who actually made it in the beginning. And that's really the first form of that. That's the most accommodating. The next level, they add a share alike or SA onto it. So share alike means others can distribute your work only under a license identical to the one you have chosen for your work. Great, that makes sense. The next level can be where they say, okay, you can only share it, but only in a non-commercial context. You can copy, distribute, display, perform for non-commercial purposes only. And that's where education typically falls under because you're not directly making money off of it. And this is something that you're sharing for education purposes. That works oftentimes. Then the other one is there's no derivative work. So you can only copy, distribute, or display verbatim. It has to be exactly the same. You can't change it in any way. So fortunately, this one does not have that on here, and that's why I can use it, because I've actually covered up some of it. Otherwise, it is verbatim to the original works. So I'm actually making use of the permissions that they've given me because it doesn't have a no derivative works on here. And so it gives you a different level. And so you can see you can combine these to the point where it's most restrictive, but it's still not as restrictive as a full copyright. And what's the point of this? Well, it actually helps a lot of groups in creating environments and communities that can then economically grow faster and share information quicker and build more value over the short and long term. And so we've seen this explode in the world of software and in music. They do it quite a bit. So, and it actually releases the stranglehold that some companies have had on all this stuff to where it breaks the doors wide open and allows a lot more innovation, a lot of new companies to innovate in the space. So Lawrence Leesig actually created a lot of the CC movement. And so this is great because this is a little bit of a video from him. And it's called Laws That Choke Creativity. And it's really talking about the some of the intellectual property laws. All right, so welcome back. So if you notice, there's completely different philosophies on how this goes from purely my work and you can't copy it, you can't do anything with it, versus everybody can use it. So instead, we have now a spectrum of sharing instead of just one way of doing things. So with that, that's it for our copyrights. And then the next topic we'll talk about is patents. Thank you.